Menopause is designated retrospectively after 12 months of amenorrhea, which is a theoretical thing. Average age is 51 years. Now it is changing. So 35 to 58, the range. High gonadotropin, low sex steroid, undetectable level of inhibin B and AMH. They are the hallmark of menopause. यहाँ से फिर आप शुरू कर सकते हो अपना थ्रू आउट ट्रांसजेंडर. नाउ यू आर नॉट वरीड ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी टिल सम स्टेम सेल कम्स इन द ओरल फॉर्म बाय बाबा रामदेव, दिस इज गोइंग इन द बॉडी एंड जनरेटिंग द ओवम. इट कैन हैपन, ही कैन, दे कैन ब्रिंग एनीथिंग ऑन द बॉडी. एन इंपॉर्टेंटली, द एज एट मेनोपॉज इज प्रोबेबली डिटरमाइंड बाय द जेनेटिक फैक्टर, बिकॉज इफ एवरीथिंग गोज in the same direction, then the age of mother and daughter actually matches for menopause. So when we take history of 20 or 30 year young girl or woman, we should ask the history of menopause in mother also. It can help us. When did your mother got natural menopause?
Elder sister also, we ask family.
Elder sister.
If they don't know, then.
Yeah, elder sister also was. True, elder sister. So genetic linkage is there. Environmental factor may modify the age at menopause, and thanks to smoking, earlier menopause, so nobody can help the smokers, so it's better. Let them stem cell at some point. DHEA and testosterone falls with aging. It is irrespective of the menopause age. Okay? Decline in estrogen is more than testosterone, and that's the reason why the androgen-estrogen ratio changes, it becomes higher in a menopausal woman, and the oral contraceptive use does not affect the age at which menopause will happen. Okay? Yeah. In most women, vasomotor symptom, depressed mood and urogenital complaint accompany the period of estrogen decline, and they respond very good to the estrogen replacement. In subsequent years, the loss of estrogen, now initial is the sudden decline and then the deficiency, is followed by a high incidence of cardiovascular disease, loss of bone mass and cognitive impairment, and all these things where estrogen replacement can work if given at a right time. And the withdrawal, hot flushes and all, they are self-limiting. Actually, even if you don't do anything about these things, they get corrected by 5 years. Most of the people 1 year and remaining by 5 years. Lot of women never experienced, they don't even know what hot flush is. They'll come, we never had it. So, smooth transition in Canada. So, we already spoken about it. Now, the question is whether the consequence of this decline, I'm talking about this statement, the question of whether the consequences of this decline are regarded to as natural or as a pathological condition, it is always a debatable issue. It is highly subjective. So there is a huge group of women in the world which say that it is absolutely a natural milestone which we are okay with, and we are well equipped how to live with that. That's absolutely fine. But there is a big group of the women in the world, they want to stay active throughout their life, sexually, professionally, economically, physically, mentally. They say that we are not going to accept this milestone of menopause as the limiting factor of our life, and they say that menopause is not the end of the life, it is a new beginning, and we want to be prepared for it. For them, HRT along with the other conventional regime are definitely a very, very good hope or area of hope and a modality to be done under supervision. And there comes the role of doctor.